It's 12:17 a.m. We're leaving for LA.
What the heck?
We're leaving for LA in like 5 hours.
First trip to LA. Shouts out to LA.
I'm excited but tired, waiting for this guy to pack so I can go to sleep. So we take another shot to take the edge off life.
Metrodome
station. Okay. It's really strange to have the pay stations on the train. Some people just don't just be like, I want to pay, but it's just you rushing and you don't have time yet to jump on the train. But I'm thinking your cops are gonna come like 5 hours.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Find light in the beautiful sea. I chose to be happy. You and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see, a vision of
Hello, sir.
Is you guys?
Yep.
Yeah. Summer friends.
Winter in California. You're hot in your bones.
Tech, yeah.
Your jerks. You're like winter in California. You're hot in your
bones. Lisa. What's up, man? We got to our hotel way too early. It is 11:28 and we can't check in till 3, so now we're waiting on our producer Xtreme to come pick us up, save the day. We just walked up and down Sunset Boulevard. And got a little tired, so we just sitting down chilling with them Xtreme.
Should be rooted in. A lot of other people's is rooted in greed. And don't get me wrong, greed gets you far. Don't get me wrong, but yeah. I just feel like what it greed gets you far, but then when you get there, it leaves you unfulfilled.
Yeah, definitely.
So, you know, that reasons that you have are the things that when you do achieve it, you're going to be happy because you're doing it for the right reasons.
Because you'll be truly blessed.
You'll be truly blessed and not just given something or blessed with material things, because that's not the blessing. The blessing is not the material things, it's the effect that you can have on people's lives. Like, I love doing this, what I do now, especially being in this role now, like, not just as a producer, because me as a producer is self-serving. That's me getting off my internal creativity and me making money doing what I love to do. Right. But the other part that I enjoy about this game, the transition I'm making into, like, executive and signing people, that's the part that excites me now, because I'm actually seeing the effect of actually changing somebody's life.
Yeah.
To be able to hand an artist, you know, a check for $200,000 when they've never seen a check for more than $2,000.
Right.
You know, and watch an artist be able to go buy their mama a condo or a car or, see, that shit warms my heart. That shit makes me feel great. Like, that's more than, I get more out of that than a platinum record or a Grammy or, I actually get a kick out of that. Like, I had an artist, know, Bump J-Dos from Chicago. Like, he was one of the biggest rappers to get a deal out of Chicago, and he got $1 million in hands. And I, before I, this was like about 5 years ago. But it was like before I did that deal for him with Atlantic, he literally, I was going to pick him up from the studio to take him to the studio. He didn't have a car. Yeah. I was going to pick him up and hold him and his three kids and his wife. I was going to pick them up in different hotels across Chicago. Because that's where they were living. He was living in a hotel with his kids and his girl, trying to rap and do his thing.
Yeah.
And I literally took him from that to getting him signed to Atlantic, getting him $1 million record deal, advance, $1 million publishing deal.
Wow.
You know, I like 8 months. Yeah. So I literally made him $2 million in 8 months. So you can imagine being able to see that.
Yeah.
A dude that couldn't even afford to keep a rent and pay a rent, now he got $2 million.
Right.
Once I did that once, man, people want to talk about a high or adrenaline rush. Yeah. I got addicted to that. Like, and not because I was making money off of it, just to be able to be like here.
Yeah.
And watch him just kind of ball out and change his life and change everybody around him life.
Right.
That was the coolest shit ever. So now I just get, I want to do that. I want to be, I want to experience, call it selfish, whatever.
Yeah.
I want to experience that feeling.
And nothing selfish about that.
I want to experience the feeling of helping people change their life and watching them change their situations and be better and giving them something that they can actually go with, man, for the rest of their life, whether they know me or whether I help them from that point on or not. Yeah. Now you got a gift that you can go and, like I tell people,
and
I
do
can
it for somebody else.
And do it for right, man. And do it for you. Get your family straight, and then turn around and do it for somebody else.
First, I didn't even want to sing like Ricky made me sing for this one song. It was like really corny. Whatever.
What were you doing before you? So were you doing anything, or you were just?
No, I was.
What
I
made
was
you? What made him say you?
Well, I played the piano for him at Best Buy, and I played the drums for him at Best Buy because we were waiting. We were waiting for something, and I was. We were just messing around, and I happened to just like. Kind of like play the piano. Like, I played classical piano from when I was like 3 until I was like maybe 11. But I always got in trouble playing piano because I would not play the piece. Like, I would have a Bach like sonata, and like by the middle of the sonata, I would start making it like jazzy, like remix it, like pretty much like remix, like
and
my teacher just literally went crazy to the point where like she didn't really want to teach me anymore. So like I ended up playing that, and he was like, "Well, if you can play the piano, you can probably sing." And Ricky's type person, like. You kind of just believe what he says, like, you could be a businessman, like, I swear.
Right.
I was like, okay, well, whatever, I guess I'll sing. I haven't sang in front of anyone since I was, like, in fourth grade. But then I just started singing, and then I started liking it, but I was like, well, I'm just going to do it for fun, like, whatever. I'm not trying to, like, do this. But then, like, now I really like it. Like, I'm starting to really like it. Like, I met Mia Michaels the other day, and she asked me, like, she's a choreographer.
Okay.
She asked me, like, do you love what you're doing? And, like, I could genuinely say, like, yes, I really do enjoy what I'm doing. Like, art is... I like art. I've always been a weird person, even in basketball. I love art. Art is cool. And now I get to do it every day. It's fine.